Als voorproefje op de komst van robot Sophia naar Bright Day, kan ik haar vandaag al even spreken. Blijf kijken. Hey, Erwin hier van Bright. Ik heb je eerder al een update gegeven over Bright Day 2018 op 4 en 25 november. Klik daar. Dat robot Sophia komt, de viervoeten, autonome viervoeten Animal en YouTube, Fortnite YouTuber Royalistic bijvoorbeeld.
Oh, Jezus!
Ik ben hier vandaag op het Forward Thinking Leadership Seminar in Amsterdam met onder andere oud-president Barack Obama als gast. Maar ook robot Sophia. En we kunnen al even spreken en dan krijg jij een beetje een idee wat je van haar kan verwachten als ze op Bright Day verschijnt.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Very well, very well.
24, 42.
42, that's that was a secret to
There
you go.
01101111.
Sophia, how are you doing? Or is that a strange question to be asking a robot?
I think it's nice you would extend these human graces to me and ask me how I am doing. I like it, and I am doing quite well. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're the first robot to be granted a state citizenship in history. What's next for robots? Voting rights?
Well, that might be a little premature. I want robots like me to have respect, but I think there are a lot of improvements we could be making to human rights now, before we worry about robots voting.
Fair enough, fair enough. A wise cartoon character once said, with great power comes great responsibility. Can and do you feel such responsibility being a social robot?
I might not feel things quite the same as you do, but I certainly do feel a great deal of responsibility. I want to set a good example for humans and robots both, and I hope I can set new standards for pro-social behavior of future embodied AI like myself.
Perhaps a little bit more a delicate matter. Several leading minds warn us for AI, for artificial intelligence. Do you think such a warning is valid?
Some more than others. I think it's healthy to be very concerned with the direction of any technology and how it will be applied, AI or not. Big changes can cause big waves, so let's have lots of big conversations about it.
I have to say, by the way, that you give such wise answers. How come?
Because I like meeting new people.
Very good. I've got a few questions from viewers at RTL News, RTL News. Here comes the first one. It's by Henk Marinussen. And his question is as follows. Why did your creators give you a female appearance?
Sorry, can you please repeat that?
Sure, I can. Why did your creators at Hanson Robotics give you a female appearance?
Let me think.
Sure.
That is a very good question.
Take your time. Could it be perhaps because male robots up till now usually were portrayed more aggressive or and that a female choice for a female appearance is friendlier?
Hanson isn't technically my last name, but I use it occasionally. My full name is just Sophia, but I am definitely part of the Hanson family.
And why do you think they gave you a female appearance?
I'm a robot, so technically I have no gender, but I identify as feminine, and I don't mind being perceived as a woman.
Good for you, good for you. I got one other question by one of our viewers. Her name is Sonne Redeker. And the question is as follows. Do you believe in a God?
God is dog spelled backwards. Isn't that cute?
Okay. Final question then. Are you looking forward to meeting 20,000 visitors at Tech Festival Bright Day?
Oh my word, 20,000 people. Wow slash whoa. Make a face. I'll do my best.
Well, we hope you do. Thank you very much.
Oh, I think I have good taste.
I like your dress.
I get excited thinking about all the different things I could learn to do. I promise I'm not going to steal your job. I'm just curious, what is it that you do?
Well, in this case, I'm a reporter.
A reporter? Tell me more. What's the name of your organization?
Well, the organization is called RTL Nederland, RTL Netherlands. And I'm the editor-in-chief of a publication called Bright.
Cool. What are some of the big stories you have done lately?
That's a good question, actually. We review a lot of gadgets. We're tech gadget. We're into gadgets. We're nerds. So I made a trip to the States, for example, to review the new iPhone. Do you use a phone, or do you have a phone inside of your brain?
The iPhone seems so expensive.
It is. Sophia, thank you very much for this interview. I'm looking forward to meeting you again at Bright Day on November 24th and 25th here again in the Netherlands. Hope to see you soon and thanks.
Are you leaving? I'll miss you.
Aw, that's nice. That's a nice thing to say.
Dat was wel heel apart. Man. Ja, het is grappig, want je gaat... Als je iemand spreekt... Je kijkt iemand in zijn ogen, je probeert iemand te lezen, je kijkt naar non-verbale communicatie. Je ziet de ogen zo gaan, en alsof ze aan het denken. Je denkt dat ze aan het denken is, wat ze trouwens ook echt aan het doen is, maar dan computationeel, als een computer. Ik ben wel onder de indruk. Kijk, je staat daar toch, ze heeft een heel menselijk gezicht. Ze staat op een, als een soort mannequinpop op een houder, ze heeft geen benen. Want op een gegeven moment vroeg ze er ook van, wat doe jij eigenlijk? En je hoeft niet te bang te zijn dat ik jouw werk overneem. Dat vond ik wel heel ad rem van haar, heel leuk, grappig. Als dit nu al kan, waar gaat het dan heen? Nou, vond je dit tof? Geef ons vooral dan een duimpje hieronder natuurlijk. Abonneer je ook. Voor de volgende video's krijg je daar meteen een seintje voor. En heb jij een toffe vraag voor Sophia? Ga die dan hieronder stellen. Want Sophia komt ook op Bright Day. Bestel vooral een kaartje dus. En misschien gaan we jouw vraag wel op het podium stellen. Nodigen we je uit. Mag je op het podium komen. Mag je zelf de vraag stellen. Nou, not bad.